Okay, if you're a pinball wizard, then downtown Tarpon Springs' newest attraction is for you. I love the Who, by the way. Hey, the Florida Replay Amusement Museum celebrating its first weekend this weekend. Over 40 pinball machines, other games. It's a fantastic idea. Joining me now, Brian Cheaney. You're the owner.
Yes.
Brian, thanks for being here.
Thank you.
Brian, first of all, tell me, where did you get this idea?
So me and my wife Becky, we're collectors by heart. So this stuff is our collection that we've had privately in our homes, our works, everywhere that we can really fit them, our bedrooms and our. So we collect these games, and we've always wanted to share it with the public. So it was one of those what if ideas, and it's kind of came to fruition in the last year.
Yeah. So what if is now what is.
Exactly.
It's there.
Exactly.
How long did it take you to collect all these games in? Because you've been doing it for a while. Obviously.
Years. Yeah. Years. It's been a bit.
What was the first game you got?
Street Fighter, actually. It's one of those games you played in the early 90s. I played it and liked it, and it always starts with one. And I say that to anybody who collects things. You start with one, and then it becomes another, and then you get over 100.
We're seeing video of some of the pinball machines here. Pinball machines still have that classic feel, do they not?
Exactly. It's a very tactile, two buttons, simple to understand, difficult to master kind of game, and that's the jewel of the museum.
I remember when I was a kid, when I saw Pong for the first time, I thought that was the most brilliant, amazing game I had ever seen in my life.
Yeah, and that's the cool thing about this is everybody has that one game they remember. You know, it could be Pac-Man, could be Galaga, could be Donkey Kong, it could be the Elton John pinball machine. We have all of that stuff here.
So tell me, you mentioned a few of them there, but you have things like Centipede. What are some of the games that you have there that people can see?
Absolutely. We have Centipede, your classics, your Donkey Kongs, your Pac-Mans. We have modern pinball machines all the way down to pinball machines from the 60s and 70s. We have Hercules, which is actually the world's largest production pinball machine. It's over 8 feet tall and uses a cue ball as a pinball.
That's awesome. Now, how does it work for people coming to the museum? Can they actually go hands-on with this stuff? Like, how, you know,
absolutely.
Do they pay to get in? Do they pay to play? Like, how does it work?
Yep. So, first thing I'd say to anybody is just to leave your quarters at home, because you pay for an admission. It's $13 for adults, $7 for children from 7 to 12, free for kids under 6. And you come in, and everything's set on free play. So you just push the button, start the game, and you can play till your fingers get sore.
You've obviously had friends come over, and that's where you're located, right? Correct?
Yep, absolutely.
Okay, you've obviously had friends come over and play these games. What's the biggest reaction that you get? Because you know it's just open to the public this weekend.
Yeah, so it's kind of neat, because what you do is you get somebody whose eyes kind of gloss over because they haven't seen something in 30 years, right? This stuff isn't in your restaurants like it was. It's not in your pool halls. It just doesn't exist in normal days and lives. So when you see somebody see something they haven't seen in 30 years and they touch it and then their muscle memory kicks in and you're in high school and you it takes you right back to that place in your memory where you played and filled quarters.
You know, it's funny, when you talk about it, you're smiling constantly.
Yeah, I'm passionate about it.
Yeah, it makes you happy. Again, where are you located?
119 Tarpon Ave. It's in downtown Tarpon Springs. Free parking. It's a little, you know, little out. It's in the Bay Area, but it's a beautiful place. We recommend anybody to come out here.
It's a must-see. Brian, thank you for being here.
Thank you very much.